1370 WOCA. Ocala.
Thank you, Mandisa. 18 minutes after 7 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in to The Source WOCA this Friday morning. Remember that point we took away on Monday? Well, give it back to yourself today. It's Friday. You'll use that extra point today, make it an extra special, extra good day. It's 63 degrees here at WOCA in the Paddock Mall. Good morning, Robin.
Good morning, Larry. How are you?
I'm a good. How are you doing?
I'm good. It's a good day today.
No. You're supposed to say Robin is good.
Oh, that's right. This is an international third person speaking day. Robin is so good today. You wouldn't believe how good Robin is.
Yes, it is. National.
National.
I was wrong about the international. It's National Speaking the Third Person Day.
Okay.
Larry's doing well, too.
Oh, Robin is so glad of that.
Yes, it is a good morning. All right, nice. It's Friday. It's Friday. We had a good day yesterday. Went and played some music at. I never know what to call them anymore. Nursing homes, assisted living facilities. I'm confused.
No, I think nursing homes,
retirement communities,
was just one entity years and years ago. But now you've got all different
mixture,
phases,
right?
in each community. So I just call it communities.
And our good friend Doug.
Robin does, yes. Robin calls it communities.
It is National Speaking the Third Person Day, so let's try to remember to speak in the third person all day today.
Robin will.
Doug, how you doing?
I'm doing okay.
No. You're supposed to say Doug is doing okay.
Doug is doing okay.
So you speak in the third person means instead of saying I, you say your own name. Okay? And I've got some famous people to tell you about who were known for speaking in the third person. I've got 11 of them.
Well,
nice. Actually, I've got 12.
Nice.
I've got a dozen of them. A dozen people who are famous for speaking in the third person.
Okay.
You never knew there was such a thing, did you?
No, I did not.
Thank you, Mandisa. Just what I need. Just what Mandisa needs. All right, let me tell you what we're doing this morning. Pastor Walter B. Smith brings a two-minute feature onto the program at 7:30. It's called Bring Back the Bible. Mm-hmm. And he, of course, is the pastor of Heritage Baptist Church. 7:35 this morning, Robin and Larry and Doug will be talking about. Yes, today is National Speaking the Third Person Day. I'll try to remember this all day.
Okay.
So mind-blowing scientific achievements. Some of these you may have heard about. Some of these it is absolutely unbelievable.
Wow.
Can I tease you with one of them real quickly?
Sure.
Okay, imagine you're driving down the road and you have an accident. It's not a bad accident, but somebody, sideswipes your car, okay? And fortunately, everybody's okay. You get out of the car, and while you're watching while you're looking at the damage, it repairs itself.
Isn't that amazing?
That must
be incredible.
Is something in this list of scientific achievements that indicates that might be a possibility in the future.
Wow, how cool is that?
How unbelievable. Wait till you hear some of these things. It's just unbelievable. All right, so we'll do that at 7:35. Jim George. Oh, I'm sorry, News Bites. News Bites at 8:35. We take the news from around the world, around the nation, around the state, and around town, if we have it. And we tell you the news short form so you can get on with your day and listen to about 20 minutes and hear about between 20 and 25 stories.
Mm-hmm.
Robin and Larry will do that.
Exactly. Larry and Robin will.
Jim George will be here at 9:05. He's the owner of American Cable Services. He always educates us about the fun things we can have in our home that are entertainment related, you know, through cable and through internet, et cetera, those kind of things.
Yeah, Jim's pretty incredible. Very smart.
Very smart. Horse Sense with the Equine Alliance of Marion County. They will be here today to talk about the industry that made Marion County famous, the horse capital of the world.
Yep.
And educate, really, the rest of us who live here or perhaps have visitors who come here and who find out, this is the horse capital. What can we go do? Well, guess what? A lot of us don't even know. And then we're intimidated. We go to a horse show. We don't know what we're looking at. We don't know who to ask. And it's amazing to hear them talk about it. So I love that.
You ask the women in the tight pants with the tall boots.
Yeah, that helps.
They're usually the riders.
That helps. You know, I do have a side subject here. It's 14 ways you know that you're a country girl.
Oh, wow. Okay.
14 ways that you know you're a country girl. I don't even know where I'm going to slip that if I'm going to use it at all.
Okay.
Ocala Magazine Radio, Kelly Hart comes in and brings us that program each Friday. It's always a delight to have Kelly in the studio.
Yeah, she's beautiful.
Another Kelly Lane at 10:35. This Kelly is a family nurse practitioner, a motivational speaker. Her book is a very thought-provoking book. It's called When God Is Silent, What Do You Do When You've Prayed and Prayed and There Seems to Be No Answer?
Yeah.
It's a very insightful, thought-provoking book. Jonathan Pierce and Jared Quidley and Mike Kohler are all going to be in the studio at 11:05. They are musicians, singers, songwriters, etc. They're all with the Blue Jays Band. In fact, they are the band that made the theme song to Horse Sense.
Yep.
And they'll be here in the studio today to talk about their concert tomorrow at Citizen Circle. They're the opening act for Sister Hazel.
Yeah, isn't that cool?
And that's very cool. It's very exciting.
Yeah, Sister Hazel's a wonderful group.
So they'll be here. Are they bringing their instruments? Are they going to give us some unplugged stuff?
I don't know. I don't know if one of the three. I know Jonathan's coming in for sure, but I'm not sure about Jared and Mike. And
no.
Is also known as Jeff.
Can I correct what you just said there? Robin is sure.
Oh, Robin is sure that Jonathan is going to be here. But Robin is not sure if Jared and Mike, who is also known as Jeff, is going to be here.
There you go.
So what happens when Mike, a.k.a. Jeff, talks in the third person? I mean, what name does he use? Does he use Mike, a.k.a. Jeff?
Yeah, that's up to him.
Oh, I see. Okay.
All right. We've got lots of silly, but some talking points that are probably more serious than what we want to do.
Yep.
There's still the news every day about the missing Malaysia airline. Flight 370. Let's see, what's the newest on this one? An analysis of radar data led them to move the search to an area about 680 miles to the northeast of where they were looking.
Wow.
So far, no tangible. Of course, they're seeing things in pictures, but so far, no ship has reached anything tangible.
Yeah, so all that debris that they thought might have been the plane isn't the plane since they're moving their search.
And in Washington, at the site of that mudslide, that horrible, horrible story, the rescue workers out there say they're not giving up. They are not giving up. They have hope that they'll find some survivors that might not survive if they don't continue. That's why they're continuing. They have at least found so far 17 bodies recovered. The toll is expected to grow today as searchers dig through the mud.
We had that horrible story too. A searcher found his own family.
The United Nations General Assembly yesterday approved a non-binding resolution calling the Crimean referendum to secede from Ukraine invalid. I don't know what that's going to mean for those people in Crimea or for the world, if we're going to go to war over this or not. I have no idea, but it is a development.
Gosh.
Mr. Obama, the president, is expected to arrive in Saudi Arabia today to discuss some common interests with us. A long list of grievances awaits him.
I bet it does.
The two nations are longtime allies bound by mutual military interests in Saudi Arabia's oil supplies, but our alliance with them has been shaken by the U.S. nuclear accord with Saudi Arabia's regional rival, Iran. Saudi leaders expressed dismay when Obama backed away from the idea of airstrikes in Syria. So,
gosh,
he'll have an earful.
Yeah, you're not kidding.
And Oscar Pistorius's trial. This is an interesting thing. I don't know anything about how the law works in South Africa. And I don't know if we have the same thing, but the trial has been put on hold because one of the two assessors was hospitalized. So the judge says, okay, we'll put the trial on hold. The question is, an assessor, the way I looked it up, and an assessor is somebody who advises the judge.
Oh, okay.
I had no idea that there was such a thing, and I don't know if we have such a thing here. And if it's that important, that's a pretty interesting thing. An assessor advises the judge.
And that's really nice because that way everybody has to be involved from start to finish. They can't excuse themselves like the, from voting or whatever our local government does to
You're making sense.
The national.
Robin is making sense.
That's what I think.
No, that's what Robin thinks.
That's what Robin thinks. Robin, I'll get it. I'm almost there.
I don't even know. I mean, Larry doesn't even know if he's doing it right. It's
Robin
speaking
thinks
the
Larry is. There you go.
All right.
I'm on track. Robin's All right. on track.
Now. I'll tell you the famous third person speakers when I guess we've got to go to Pastor Walter B. Smith first. So those were some of the serious things that are happening in the world right now. And here in our own backyard, let's see, an 18-year-old man tried to avoid being arrested for 8 hours yesterday in Fort McCoy. He was in his girlfriend's mobile home.
Uh-huh.
Nobody got hurt, thank goodness, but the SWAT team was called out.
Gosh.
And I guess he was on probation. Violation of probation was what they were going after him for. Mm. He is Matthew Allison Thomas, and he's now in jail. But nobody got hurt, which is a good thing.
You know, they get out, they're supposed to be rehabilitated, and
it doesn't happen.
They do, stupid stuff. So Robin does not feel sorry for them.
This is the craziest thing.
Robin likes it.
Okay. Yeah. Well, so does Larry. Larry likes it, too. The 26-year-old woman who was accused of faking a May-December romance to get $20,000 from an 85-year-old man surrendered.
There you go.
She was, this is what happened
Women
to them.
Women are...
This is what happened. Do you know what happened? Do you know the story?
No, I don't.
All right,
Robin doesn't
know. When was this? I do have the date here somewhere. November 30th, 2012. The man here remembers the date well.
I bet he does.
He was at a Walgreens on November 30th, 2012. And the girl in front of him was... Gina Marks. This is the woman who turned herself in. Gina Marks was a dollar short at the checkout line in Walgreens. So Mr. Clifford Rogerson was standing behind her. He said, here's the dollar. He took care of her. And she's a cute girl. He's an 85-year-old man, or he is now. This was a couple years ago. All right, so he was 83.
83.
And she would have been what? 24? No. Yeah. Yeah, 24. She would have been 24. He's 83. Okay. So she's a dollar short. He helps her out. She's so grateful. He asks her out.
Of course.
Like any imbecile would.
That's right. That's what anybody would do.
Because men are imbeciles when it comes to pretty women. We are absolute imbeciles. So anyway, so he asks her out. And they go out. And the relationship develops. They start kissing, holding hands, the whole thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
She needs some money every now and then, of course.
Probably,
$20,000 and his entire retirement savings, by the way, gone. He didn't really have much in savings, did he? But anyway, she took his whole thing, which was $20,000. And that was the last he heard of her.
Robin bets that.
Robin bets it. So does Larry. Anyway, but she turned herself in now, so wow.
Her conscience was working.
Could be, yeah.
Robin's so glad.
And there's a 26-year-old mom. She's got two children, and she also has multiple sclerosis. She is heading to Chicago. She's from Florida. She's heading to Chicago because there's a doctor there who can use her stem cells to, what do you call it when you stop something? Put her multiple sclerosis in remission. He can't undo the damage that it has caused, but he can stop it.
That
he can
is
stop
wonderful.
It from getting worse. And she says
Thank
she
God.
Feels like she'll get her life back. He says only 7% of the patients he's applied this procedure to have gone into remission. The other 93% went on without the multiple sclerosis progressing.
Wow.
How about that, huh?
That is
She's
so
in
amazing.
The news for one simple reason. She says a lot of people don't even know about this therapy. She mm-hmm. wants it in the news so that people like you and I, Robin and Larry, will talk about it. And maybe perhaps bring some awareness to some people who could use it. 400,000 people in America have multiple sclerosis, by the way.
Well, maybe some doctors in Florida then will get on a plane and go this up there, talk to the guy, and bring it back home.
I always wonder about these things. Why is it that we have a specialist that we need to go to? Why doesn't that specialist teach everybody else so that we don't need to go to one guy?
Yeah.
You heard about that one specialist in Boston, remember? Mm-hmm. The brain specialist who helped out people?
Yeah.
He was a guest on the show.
Yes.
All right, we've got to push forward. Pastor Walter B. Smith is up with Bring Back the Bible, and then we'll be back. I've got some amazing scientific achievements, and I'll also tell you some famous Larry will also tell you some famous third-person speakers on this National Speak in the Third Person Day.
Yes.
Robin and Larry and Doug.
Yes.
We'll be right back after this.
Well, a good day to you, and welcome again to Bring Back the Bible. I'm Pastor Smith, coming to you as always from Heritage Baptist Church over here on Northeast 20th Street in the northeast section of Ocala. Well, today is Friday, and that means it's the day before the weekend. And I hope and pray that you'll find yourself this Sunday in a Bible-believing, Bible-preaching church. I would certainly encourage you to come to Heritage Baptist Church. We're just off of Northeast 8th Avenue here in the northeast section of Ocala on Northeast 20th Street. Love to have you come and be a part of our Sunday school at 9:30, the morning service at 10:30, or the evening service at 6:30. And we also have services every Wednesday at 7 o'clock. That's right. We still preach the Bible. We still sing from the hymn book. And we still have church on Sunday night and Wednesday night. A custom that is ours to keep, and we're proud of it. I might also say this morning that for almost the last year, just a month or two short of a year, it's been my privilege to bring this two-minute broadcast every morning at 7:30 on WOCA. Call Bring Back the Bible, and we certainly need to bring back the Bible. We need a revival of the Bible in America. All these problems that are surfacing politically and morally and all these other areas of our society could be cured, by returning back to the Bible. But this will be our last broadcast of Bring Back the Bible. And we are discontinuing this broadcast on this station. We've enjoyed doing it. And I thank God for all those that have listened in very faithfully. God bless each and every one of you. Personal safety.
Your home is safe, or is it? AA Lock, Dock, and Security. The name has been a staple in Ocala since 1985. Do you have the right equipment in place to have peace of mind when you are at home or away? AA Lock, Dock, and Security has the right people to install and monitor your home or business. Call today for a free on-site security analysis. Call 867-1965. AA Lock, Dock, and Security, 219 Northwest 10th Street, 867-1965.
When it comes to truck month, bigger is better, and nobody has a bigger selection or better prices than Palm Chevrolet of Ocala. And this week only at Palm Chevrolet of Ocala, every truck in our huge inventory will be marked down to our final sacrifice price.
We've been instructed.